Too often in sports, we worry about how a team will do, how their season will turn out according to the experts, even before they run a single play. The 2009 Wildcats didn't worry about such things. They simply concerned themselves with getting better each week. Confident that effort and technique can make all the difference. Football at St. Ignatius is not about predictions. It's about how you play the game.
Five of these games that we won, we were behind. Regular season, we could have been 5-5 on a heartbeat. I mean, people look at the games, that's a possibility, but we weren't.
The tone for the season was set in the opening game against Glenville, another dramatic affair of ebbs and flows. Despite having the better of it on both sides of the ball in the first half, a blocked punt had the Wildcats behind by 3 at intermission. The hitting was fierce as play continued in the second half. And the deficit grew to 6 moving into the fourth quarter. It was time for some big plays. Jake Ryan and the defense stopped one fourth down play. Peter Russo's punt pinned Glenville deep, and the defense again stepped forward in swarming fashion to give the offense one more chance.
It was 20 yards that we needed to go. We needed to get that 20 yards because we worked so hard all game. And it was up to us in the final couple of minutes there to where we know we need to put it in.
I thought the kids kept their composure very well and really gave us good information.
The receivers on the backside said that they were wide open when we called the timeouts. The
play that ended up being a touchdown, we actually ran the previous play. Corey Gillespie was open.
The second play was a touchdown. Corey was coming off, he was doing like a post dig kind of thing. You know, Mark threw it across his body, put a perfect throw right on him, and you know, Corey made a real nice catch. So, I mean, I was going nuts in the field.
Jesse Franklin's subsequent extra point gave the Wildcats a lead that seniors Tom Crookmeyer, Jerry Romella, and the rest of the defense made certain would not be relinquished. Clayton Northmont would test the mettle of this team in the following week. Building a 20-0 lead late in the second quarter. How would the Wildcats answer the challenge?
You know, the two-minute drill in the first part of the season, you don't expect it's going to go very well because you really haven't had a whole lot of time to work on it. Mark was new at the two-minute offense. He hadn't run it. And so here we go, and going down the field. And one play after another, zip, 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 and right down the field. And all of a sudden, we're in the end zone. And that was a great drive. It's a great momentum changer right before the half.
After the break, All-Ohio linebacker Jake Ryan and the defense took over.
Defense came right out and really a series of plays that were just total dominating and really attacked. And sometimes you have to go ahead and attack.
the big thing was talking about what we had to do at halftime and coming back after halftime. Jake had the big hit, the biggest hit of the season probably.
Hit where there was a fumble and all that. I think that kept from the momentum we got from the drive right before halftime, and then we got that defensive play where it really did take the first team quarterback out of it. He just was not the same the rest of the game. In fact, they put somebody else in, and we scored there. Well, the momentum was clearly in our favor at that point.
But the defense was just getting started. Two more seniors, Kevin Hopkins and Kevin Johnson, team up to force another turnover. A Mark Myers to Tucker Sorrell pass kept the positive vibe going. And then it was junior Bobby Graben's turn. On a night with over 170 yards on the ground, this touchdown and a Jesse Franklin PAT gave the Wildcats their first lead. The defense continued to do its thing in the final 24 minutes. And the offensive line created openings for the Wildcats to exploit on the ground. Kevin Johnson's touchdown capped the largest comeback in terms of points in school history. Memorable comeback number 3 came against the Massillon Tigers. Ignatius moved the ball well in the first half, building a 2-touchdown lead. Only to have the Tigers use big plays to take the advantage with less than 4 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Senior Anthony Lubison stepped forward, making big plays on both sides of the ball. This Bobby Graben's touchdown made it a 1-point game. With time running out, Jake Ryan's sack gave the offense another chance. Grabenz, who had 210 yards rushing on the night, helped power the ball close. Maslin thought it slammed the door with this interception, but the Tigers were guilty of holding. Watch tight end Brandon Carazzoni get bear hugged, and the penalty flag flew before the interception was made. With renewed life, Grabenz rolled into the end zone on a perfectly executed draw play. The comeback was complete.
Bobby's touchdown against NASA, there is a huge hole there. I mean, watching him just walk in the end zone, nobody around him, I mean, that's a pretty good experience or feeling to have.
The win by the Wildcats was their 12th in 13 meetings against Massillon. You may not know this, but a football field is normally laid out with specific geographical assignments. For a Wildcat offense that averaged over 31 points and nearly 330 yards per game, they knew which direction to go, north and southbound. All-Ohio quarterback Mark Myers directed the attack, displaying a rifle arm that provided more than 2,100 yards and 20 touchdowns. He did that with only senior tight end Brandon Carazzoni having any experience as a target. On the outside, seniors Anthony Lubison, Tucker Sorrell, and Corey Gillisey teamed up with junior David Joseph for 76 catches and 12 scores. Others like Zach Strippy and Blake Thomas showed potential for next season. The offensive line was a mix of seniors and juniors who relished their chance to contribute. Joe Lavelle and second-team All-District Stuart Ross built on their experience from 2008 at the tackle spots, as did classmates Drew Gadian and Chris Chapik. Chapik was an All-Ohio special mention honoree. Juniors Michael Ramos and Mason Halder will provide leadership next year. The line especially enjoyed opening holes for junior running back Bobby Grabenz. Named to the All-Ohio second team, Grabenz provided power and speed, rushing for nearly 1,250 yards and scoring 17 times. Kevin Johnson, Anthony Masha, Joe Gorsica, and Christian Sanders also toted the pigskin. For the Wildcats, it's not east side, west side. It's going north and southbound. A football schedule provides an interesting roadmap each season, but for the Wildcats, the highlighted regular season games are always the battles with St. Xavier and St. Edward.
I really enjoy going against Xavier because I have a lot of respect for Steve Speck and their coaching staff. They do a great job. It really is a chess match going against them.
The two Jesuit schools coming together, and it's always a battle with them. It's a battle with the kids, you know, playing hard, who's going to play harder, who's going to play better. But also, who's going to coach better?
Their kids are just like our kids, Jesuit educated. They know how important those kinds of games are.
And, you know, playing at Carroll was just an unbelievable experience. I mean, you know, it was a sold-out crowd. You could really feel that rivalry in the air.
The game at John Carroll against St. X, to no surprise, featured an early Wildcats deficit. But the defense kept coming up with turnovers that senior kicker Jesse Franklin turned into points. Leaping end zone pickoff by Kevin Johnson kept the Cats behind by just one at intermission. Early in the third, the ground game got into gear. Watch the blocks, yes, plural blocks, on this Bobby Grabenz run by fullback Scott McVay. Another Franklin field goal out of the hold of Joe Greco gave Ignatius its first lead. More stout defensive play. Senior George Narones with a pick six, and the Ignatius advantage grew. St. X would respond with a score, but the offense again had an answer. Clutch catches by Sorrell and Lubison kept a drive going. culminating in a Mark Myers laser shot to David Joseph. St. X refused to go away, but no worries. The line popped Bobby Gravens free for a 56-yard clincher and a 30-21 win. Now with a shot at a perfect regular season, the road would run through Lakewood.
I mean, with the 9-0 season, you want to go 10-0, and it couldn't be any better than going against your biggest rival in St. Ed's.
I mean, every year everyone's ready for Ed's. I mean, I think the only time we've lost them was freshman year, so we want to just keep it going, have a nice Ignatius win streak against Ed's. So, I mean, we didn't really need much motivation for that game.
It was a solid performance all around against the Eagles. The defense banging away and the offense making big plays. Bobby Gerben's 50-yard burst put the Wildcats on the board. St. Edward wanted to pound it out on the ground, but the defense would have none of it. The next big play on O was through the air. A perfect strike from Mark Myers to David Joseph. 14-0, Ignatius. No matter what formation the Eagles tried, Jerry Romella, Jake Ryan, Pat Dowd, and Scott McVay led the Ignatius shutdown crew. To start the second half, the offense showed great balance. Using Mark Myers' strong arm, before turning it over to Bobby Gravens and the O-line when they got down close. Back on D, things were no better for the Eagles after intermission. The offense would follow the same script on its next drive, mixing the run and the pass. Another Graben score wrapped up a very satisfying 28-0 shutout and a 10-0 regular season record.
It is our message. It's the Ignatius football team. It's the Ignatius defensive message that, you know, you got to play hard on every down, every play, and take it one play at a time. And what do I have to do to get better on this next snap? And just go out and do it. I think it's like an approach to anything in life is that you get some adversity, well, deal with it and let it happen.
And that's exactly what the Ignatius defense did in 2009, turning in another terrific effort despite a difficult schedule and a group with less starting experience than many earlier Wildcat teams. Embracing the philosophy of trying to get better on each play and displaying the best principles of a team approach, the Wildcats proved to be a formidable unit. Only three starters returned, but seniors Scott McVay, Jerry Romella, and Pat Dowd were outstanding leaders. McVay battled a shoulder problem all season, but was still second-team All-Ohio, while Romella and Dowd, a second-team All-District, anchored the line despite often facing a considerable size disadvantage. Fellow seniors Tom Crookmeyer and Cameron Ventling also turned in solid play. District Defensive Player of the Year and first-team All-State linebacker, Jake Ryan had a wonderful year, leading the team with 104 tackles and 8 sacks. Fellow senior linebacker Owen Callahan had 100 tackles in his first year as a starter, and junior Tyler Ketty and sophomore James Sheehan showed promise among the linebacking core. It was a new group in the secondary, although a number saw significant time last season. Co-captain Kevin Hopkins was All-District, as was George Narones, who led the team in interceptions. Kevin Johnson, Corey Gillisey, Anthony Lubison, Marcus Primes, and Kyle Nada were large contributors in their final seasons in a Wildcat uniform. With sophomore Mike Spatina also helping the cause. They always had their game face on, a unit better than its individual parts. But that's the way the Wildcats play defense. For the 22nd straight time, an ongoing state record, Ignatius found itself in the playoffs, this year against another familiar foe, the Boardman Spartans. It was a typical smash-mouth affair against the team from the Youngstown area. Cats broke on top in the first period when Mark Myers scrambled to keep the drive alive with a completion to Anthony Lubison and then hit sophomore tight end Blake Thomas, who found the end zone. McVay, Callahan and company kept the Spartans at bay, and late in the second, David Joseph got free in the Boardman secondary. And with a block from Tucker Sorrell, went 79 yards with the Myers pass, the second longest score through the air in Ignatius playoff history. The second half featured more of that Wildcat team defense. Scott McVay led the way with 10 tackles, but he had plenty of help. A Corey Gillissey punt return put the offense in business. Where Anthony Lubison's catch set up Jesse Franklin's 23-yard field goal. For the second straight week, the defense pitched a shutout, 17-0. Up next, a rematch with Glenville. Coming into the regional semifinals, Ignatius and Glenville had only tasted defeat over the past two seasons when facing each other. Unfortunately, it was a nightmare beginning. The Cats would turn the ball over five times in the game's first 15 minutes and trail 23-0. But that didn't mean they didn't make some big plays during that time, as they struggled to find some consistency. Starting inside their own 20, with 8 minutes to play in the first half, the offense got started. A Grabenz run and a tough Brandon Carazzoni catch put the ball near midfield.
The Wildcats will go with four wide as Joseph goes in motion. Myers deep. He's got Joseph open. He's got it. He's gone. Touchdown. St. Ignatius on the board.
Regaining possession late in the quarter, a fortunate bounce and a little razzle-dazzle put the Cats on the move again.
So now they're going to go with the Wildcat. Corey Gillissey, number 21 there, is the quarterback on second and 10 at the 41. And a little trickery. Myers, the quarterback, going to go back to left side for Benz. Did he make the catch? He held on!
Mark Myers' scramble in the closing seconds cut the lead to 10 at halftime. When not handcuffed by field position from the turnovers, the defense was effective. And midway through the third, they produced their own break.
Third down and 9 at the 38 for Glenville. Jones with time. Flags come in Now the pocket's closing down, and Jones just tosses it up there. Picked off! Here comes George Nerones! The Wildcats have their first turnover if the penalty indeed is against Glenville. But perhaps trying to do too much, the Wildcats' dream of another comeback was thwarted at the goal line. The effort remains strong. Right until the game's final play. But a wonderful season came to an end short of its final destination. The effort by the 2009 Wildcats will long be remembered when final results are forgotten. And that's how it should be.
This season, you know, the undefeated regular season and how the season ended, I will remember that or those things at all. It's more the kids and just how they played and, you know, always played tough. And they always played hard. They never gave up. It was every, you know, this is my job, I'm going to do it. I think that's the great learning lesson for these kids, but I think also a learning lesson for anyone who follows Ignatius football and things like that. That's what it takes to be a winner.
It's a simple formula. Play St. Ignatius football.
St. Ignatius football is 48 minutes of going at it every single play, trying to be better than the guy across from you.
It means doing it right. I mean, Coach Kyle talks about it every day in practice, all the coaches, not just him. It's doing it right, you know, every single rep, every single play of the game, you know, never taking a play off because you're out there with your teammates battling for them.
When those concepts are applied, these young men and their coaches achieve wonderful results.
Oh, it's awesome playing with Coach Kyle. He just gets you ready to play, and I mean, there's no greater motivator out there, and you want to make him proud and keep his legacy going about how his winning tradition at Ignatius.
You come out of that locker room, you know, ready to do everything you possibly can to win. And I mean, it's just been special for me, and I've actually lived the tradition. It's been awesome.
The tradition, the ties of new days from the old. That's St. Ignatius football.
I've been watching football games ever since I was 5 years old at the St. Ignatius football game. So it's always been like this goal I've had to play for Ignatius, and it meant a lot.
The experience that you have here is just something that I don't think you'll ever get anywhere else. Playing for Coach Kyle is like playing for no other coach.
Coach Kyle puts it best when he says, don't look at the scoreboard. We try and take that to heart because any circumstance doesn't matter. It matters how you play. You know, you have the gold helmet with the paws, you're wearing the Boone gold, and that's what matters, is that you're playing football for St. Ignatius. We're not worried about the score or any other circumstance. It's about playing hard and representing the school and your teammates.
Each time the 2009 St. Ignatius Wildcats took the field, they did it with a sense of commitment, a belief in each other, a deep understanding of how you play the game.
But what these kids did was what a great team has to do. Again, take your talents, do what you can, and then keep your poise and have faith in the scheme and the techniques and of the guys around you, and find a way.
Nothing was easy, but I would do it all again and never change a thing. It's all about choices, but I couldn't watch you walk away without following. Oh, what I'd give to be December boys again. Took me by surprise, it felt so good.
Thank you and good night.